This is Vachila, working as an associate professor in the Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. It's a part of the Database Management Systems lecture series. Today, I will discuss about the extended relational algebra operators. Last two sessions, I discussed about the basic operators of relational algebra as well as derived operators of the relational algebra. The basic six operators are there, and based upon these six operators, four additional operators are defined to reduce the complexity of the queries. These derived operators doesn't add any power to our relational algebra. But certain cases, certain requirements of the user cannot be expressed through these existing operators. So that's why we need some more additional operators so that all users' requirements or all users' queries can be expressed effectively. For this purpose only, we are having the third category of operators of relational algebra as extended relational algebra. This adds some power to the existing or basic relational algebra. Some additional power is going to be added and additional operators are added so that the expressive power can be increased. Extended relational algebra operations are generalized projection, outer join, aggregate functions, and DML operations. Basically, we consider this relational algebra as a query language. As I discussed earlier, query language need not contain only query statements. As per the requirements of the user, it will include all facilities of definition and manipulation operations also. As a part of that, relational algebra also includes DML operations also. So first we'll discuss about generalized projection. We are aware that projection is an operator which will display the required attributes, details of a relation. That is, its vertical fragmentation of the relation. So general syntax of the projection is pi and the list of attributes of a relation. So whichever the list of attributes we specified in the projection operator pi, the respective attribute values are going to be displayed to us actually. But if any operations or arithmetic process has to be done on these attribute values for all tuples, then we cannot do this. We have to first update the database or table, then it has to be listed out. But this generalized projection extends the projection operation by allowing arithmetic functions can be used in our projection list. So concatenation of two attributes, a1 plus a2. I can write directly the expression in this generalized projection. The general syntax of the generalized projection is pi f1, f2, etc. fn of E, where E is any relational algebra or relational algebraic expression, and f1, f2, f3, etc. fn are arithmetic expressions involving constant and attributes in the scheme of E. So for example, I want to get the increase of a salary by 20%. Then I'll write sal plus sal star 0.2. Then automatically I'll get the, instead of getting original salary, increase of the salary. That is, I able to write the expression as, instead of writing salary, I'll write sal plus sal multiplied by 0.2. Then this provides us the respective increment in the salary instead of having the original salary of the attribute or each employee. So each of these F1, F2, etc., FN are arithmetic expressions as well as attributes and constant combinations will be there as per the requirement of the query. Example, given a relation credit information, customer name, limit and credit balance. The query is like this. Find how much more each person can spend. Credit limit will be there. For example, maximum 50,000 I can spend. Right? So, I already spent 30,000. Then, how much amount I can spend further? 50,000 minus 30,000, that is 20,000 I can spend. That is customer name, limit and credit balance was given to us. Based upon this, limit minus credit balance gives us how much further that particular customer can spend on that particular credit card. So instead of writing separate expression, we will write this generalized projection as you observe pi customer name and the second attribute is limit minus credit balance. Limit minus credit balance provides us how much a person can spend further. That is an arithmetic expression of two attributes involved, which is not allowed in our general, normal or a basic projection. But this is allowed only in the generalized projection only. Right? So similarly, sometimes we would like to get some information on a particular attribute or more than one attribute related to aggregate values. I want to get maximum marks of a student in a subject or number of students available in that particular table, count, average mark of the student in a particular subject. What are all these things? Average, maximum, total, minimum, maximum, etc. All these are known as aggregate functions. Most of the time, we need these aggregate values to be get displayed actually. So, aggregate function must be included in our relational algebra so that the grouping of the tables or grouping of the tuples, finding the aggregation of the values of the table or groups can be easily identifiable by us. So, this extended relational algebra supports aggregate functions and operations. So, what is an aggregate function? Aggregate function takes a collection of values and returns a single value as the result. So, collection of values means, for example, I want to get total salary paid by that particular organization. Total salary paid by that particular organization means salary is my output. Salary is our respective variable. So, for all employees, salary must be total. That is, I have to calculate total of the salary attribute. That is the amount spent by the organization towards the salaries actually. So, I need to calculate total of all people, all employees' salaries. That can be found by using sum aggregate function. So, what are the input? Input will be all employees' salaries. That is, collection of values are input. And what will be the output? A single value. That is sum of the salaries of the employees. That is a single value. So for all aggregate functions, the input will be collection of values and it returns a single value. The aggregate functions supported by this relational algebra are average, minimum, maximum, sum, count. Count and count star is also there. So, that will be represented in SQL. So, average, minimum, maximum, sum count. These are the five aggregate functions supported by relational algebra. How these aggregate functions are used? These aggregate functions are used by using aggregate operations. So, aggregate operation is represented by using a group operator G. This is the general syntax of our aggregate operations. G1, G2, G3, etc., Gn of, this is the G of, with the suffixes, F1 of A1, F2 of A2, etc., Fn of An of relation expression E. So, what is E? E is any relational algebraic expression, or it may be any relational. In that, G1, G2, G3, etc., Gn, F1, F2, etc., Fn. These G1, G2, G3, etc., Gn are the list of the attribute on which the grouping has to be done. These must be considered for grouping. For example, if you have a student relation, I may be taking average mark of each branch, average mark of the each branch. Then I'll take the first grouping is on done on the branch. Branch of what I need to know? Average mark. So AVG of mark of student. So, student is our relation. So, we are using this student. What we are computing here? So, we are computing here the average mark of the student, but not all students. Branch wise I need actually. So, if branch wise required, then I will use branch name as my grouping attribute. So, what are the G1, G2, G3, etc., Gn means grouping attributes. So, branch I am taking as a grouping attribute means, so for example, in my institution, three branch students are there, CSE, EEE, and ECE. Three branch students are there. So, the entire student group is going to be grouped into three categories, having branch name as CSE as one group, EEE as another group, ECE as another group. Three groups are made. On that, what I am doing? I am applying average of mark. For each group, this average of mark is going to be computed. So, I will get three averages. One average for CSE, one average for EEE, one average for ECE. So, what are these F1 of A1, etc.? We are doing F1, F2, etc. are aggregate functions, and A1, A2, etc. are attributes on which the aggregate functions are evaluated. In this example, average of mark, I am specifying. Average of mark means average is my aggregate function, F1. Mark is A1, that attribute name actually. Similarly, I may take two things also. So, for example, I would like to consider two types of grouping functions. For the same student, if I am going to consider the student attribute, for student STD only I will use for convenience purpose, that's all. So, student is STD tuple. I am using two groups. What are the two groups? Branch name is one group. Another group I am making, year. If you are using two grouping attributes, first it will group on the branch name. Within each group, again year wise will be considered. And I am doing this aggregate function. Same I am using average of mark only, M1 I will take, let us assume that, of STD, student. Now, what will be the output for this? The entire student is first grouped branch wise, that is three groups are there, CSE group, right? EEE, ECE. Three groups will be there. Again, within that group, year. That means in CSE, again, you will get first year, second year, third year, fourth year, year-wise. Or semester-wise means you will get 8 semesters. Similarly, under triple E also, you will get first year, second year, third year, fourth year. Like that each. For each of these things, you will get the averages. That means totally, I'll get 12 averages. CSE for 4 years and ECE for 4 years and EEE for 4 years. So, totally, we will get the average of 4 entire years actually. 3 branches and 4 years. Like that, we can do aggregation. Right? Aggregate operations are going to be performed on attributes. For example, here we have given G of some C or here I didn't give any grouping, only aggregate operations. Those are also can be performed. So on C attribute, sum is calculated. C is 77310. So total is 27. Sum C will be on C attribute is 27 without grouping. Another example is there here. Relation account grouped by branch name here. So, how many branches are there? 3 branches are there. So, it will be grouped. What is the aggregate function? Sum of the balance. So, per each 2 tuples are there. 900 plus 400, 1300. Right? And Brighton is going to be 750 plus 750, 1500. And Redwood is going to be only 1700. So, on branch name, the grouping was done. After doing that branch name grouping, the balance is going to be calculated. Some of the balances are calculated. So, the result of aggregate function does not have a name. So, that's why whatever the function we are taking, the rename operation can be used to give a different name. For convenience, we can rename it as a part of the aggregate operations only. So, as we can use rename, so branch name G, sum of the balance as sum balance. Sum balance is an attribute name given. For these sum values, that will be get displayed actually. Another one we'll discuss, the next one. We already have an idea about the join operation. Join operation is an additional operation of the relational algebra. So, by using this join operation, if you observe, join operation is natural join on the common attribute, common values are going to be joined here. So, based upon this, in this example, A department on department, because department is a common to these two tables on department, B is equal to B, B is equal to B, only those are going to be joined. I'll get Jones B black, Smith B black. Now, you observe here, some of the tuples doesn't display in the join operation. We are losing some information sometimes. That is, some tuples don't contribute to the result because they are not having any common attribute values. And because of that, loss of information is possible. So, that's why to avoid this loss of information, special cases of the join is identified as an outer join. An extension of the join operation that avoids the loss of information is an outer join. That means in the previous slide, which we considered brown A, C white. From the first table, brown A, and from the second table, C white. These two tuple information was not included because of this join constraint actually. And that information was lost. Such type of loss of information can be avoided by using this outer join. In this outer join, it computes first join, then adds tuples of the one relation that do not have a match tuples in the other relation to the result of the relation by inserting null values in the respective attributes where the data is not there. Outer join extends those tuples with null values that would get lost by an inner join operation. That means if there is no matching, those are going to be lost, no? those tuples are going to be included in the outer join by adding null values for the attributes which doesn't have at all. Outer join comes in these three versions: left outer join, right outer join, full outer join. Left outer join keeps the tuples of the left argument, extending them with null values if necessary. Right outer join keeps the tuples of the right argument, that is right relation, extending them with nulls if the necessary. Full outer join means both arguments unmapped tuples are going to be listed. These outer join uses null values. Null signifies that the value is unknown or does not exist. Comparison involving null values are, generally speaking, false by definition. And if necessary, we can discuss more about the null at the time of processing the queries. Example of outer join. We will represent notations, maybe a slight variation will be there depending upon the implementation wise. Here we will represent join was represented by using a symbol. This is the symbol of join. So outer join includes a open window. If it is left side open, if it is right side open, if both means it will be on both sides, a window will be opened. Now we will consider two relations, loan relation and borrower relation. Loan relation consists of the loan number, branch name and amount. Borrower relation consists of the customer name, loan number. When we are joining them, the common attribute is loan number, which is having common values that will be listed in the inner join actually, or general join. So inner join means loan. You observe the symbol which we are using, loan borrower, and we will get, this is the two tuples are having mapping 170 and 230. The respective data will be displayed. You observe here in the previous loan number, branch name, amount is there. In addition to that, in join, we will get customer name also. When you are joining both, loan number is common, no? So that's why it will be displayed only once. So what are the common values are there? L170, L230, these are two are common. So when join, these two tuples only listed in general. General join actually. It is a join, or we will call it as a natural join. Left outer join means you observe left side open window is there. That is, left side open means left side at relation, whichever the tuples are not listed in an inner join, that will be included. So we will get like this, L170, L230 will be as usual of the natural join, and then we will get the respective values. So when we are having these values, respective values from the inner join, we will get L170, L230, L260, and L260 is not having any mapping, but left side is open, no? So the left side values are included. Left side values means loan number, branch name, amount will be included, for which there is no mapping with the customer name. So that's why customer name will become null value. So we are not losing the information from the loan relation, right? So similarly, right outer join means right side amount, that is borrower relation, will be added, and the left side relation tuple attributes are filled with null values. So loan number, branch, amount are not there. Loan number is there, 155. And amount and branch are not there. That will be null, and customer name will be there. That is, HES L155 is a tuple in your borrower. So that is included even though there is no matching, because outer join on the right hand side, open on the right hand side means all tuples of the right hand side relation must be included. Even though there is a mapping, mapped tuples are going to be included. If there is no mapping, then null values are included in the respective attributes for which the data is not available. Full outer join means both sides data will be included even though there is no matching, so that the information loss from both relations can be avoided. Now you observe total four tuples we got. The first two tuples are having a mapping. The next tuple is left side data is there, right side attribute customer name is not there. The fourth tuple and right side information is available. So that's why left side attributes, branch name, amount is not available. Now, because of this type of full outer join, we may avoid the loss of information actually. In some situations, such type of loss of information is required at the time of joining the two or more relations actually. So one more example I'm taking, employee department, you observe B is equal to B. So B, you are going to have A, B, B. B is mapping. Now left means, this is another notation. Instead of you using window, you can use left, right words also. Left employee and brown A is added, for which no head, so head is null. Right outer, if you are considering, and right side is B is having a mapping, but with C no mapping, C white are added, for which no employee will become null. Full outer means, first mapped data will be there, Jones B block, Smith B black will be there. In addition to that, brown A, C white are included. The remaining tuples, attributes are null actually. So null values are very effectively used in our outer joins. For tuples have null values denoted by null, some other their attributes. Null signifies an unknown value or does not exist. So that's why null values are involving arithmetic operations which are involved with null values will be a null actually. So 50 plus null will be 50. You are going to consider as any arithmetic expression involving null is a null only. Because we don't have value not to do this one process actually. So 50 plus null means null only. It's not 50. If it is 50, null will become considered as a zero as per the arithmetic rules actually. Aggregate function simply ignore the null values. When you are calculating sum, average, etc., it will ignore the null values. It's an arbitrary decision generally. Could have return null as a result also sometimes instead of that. We follow the semantics of SQL in handling these null values generally. But what is SQL semantics? We'll discuss during the SQL sessions actually. For duplicate elimination and grouping also, null is treated like any other value. So that's why it is not considered as a repeated value or a duplicate value. Because null means unknown, no? So that's why it cannot be considered as a duplicate value. Two nulls are assumed to be same. Alternatively, sometimes assume each null is different from the other null, or both are arbitrary decision. It all depends upon the specific commercial software developed. So generally, SQL has its own rules and regulations while comparing and while using these nulls actually. The last extended relational algebraic operation is modification of the database, that is DML commands. DML means deletion of records, deletion of tuples from the relation, insertion of tuples in our relation, as well as updating of the some attribute of the tuples. These operations are generally expressed by using assignment operator as well as set operators actually. So for example, we'll consider delete. So if you want to delete any request, for example, I would like to delete some tuple. First assign that particular tuple a relation, then remove that particular tuple from the relation, that is minus. A delete request is expressed similarity to a query, except instead of displaying the tuple to the user, the selected tuples are removed from the database. How to do this actually? We can delete only whole tuple, cannot delete values for only particular attribute. If you want to delete, you can delete entire record or entire tuple can be deleted, but not a part of the tuple. An attribute value, salary of employee can be deleted. No, it cannot be deleted. So if you want to delete the entire tuple, the expression is like this. R is assigned as R minus E, where E is a relational algebraic query which consists of or which results a tuple to be deleted actually. That means from the relation, the deleted tuple sub-relation is removed, means that is assigned to again our original relation, means the tuples are deleted. Example, delete all accounts records in the Parage branch. So how to get the records of a Parage branch? Selection operation. Sigma branch name is equal to Parage of account. Sigma branch name is equal to Parage of account. This provides us all records of the Parage branch or all tuples of the Parage branch account. All accounts of the Parage branch. These must be deleted means, what is our original relation? Original relation is account. From the account original relation, these tuples are removed and that is assigned back to original relation means that is deleted only. Similarly, delete all loan records with the amount ranging from 0 to 50. First, I suppose to find out the loan tuples which is having loan value amount as 0 to 50. That can be considered by using a relational algebraic expression sigma. So, sigma amount is greater than or equal to 0 and amount is less than or equal to 50 means it is ranging from 0 to 50 of loan. So, this expression, the second part of this expression provides us a list of all loans which are having within the range from 0 to 50. What we are doing? Minus, set minus operation. Loan minus these attributes. From loan, I am removing these attributes. Then the result, what is the result? The remaining attributes, loan minus these tuples. The remaining tuples will be there. The remaining tuples I am assigning back to my original relation. That means the original relation consists of the tuples by deleting the specified tuples. Like that, delete all accounts at branches located in Needham. So, sigma branch city is equal to Needham, account into account join branch we will consider because branch city is there in our branch relation and we want to take all accounts means from account, a natural join is performed. R1 is that one. R2 is branch name and account number balance of R1. And R3 is we are making the specific attributes from these R2 and depositor. Then we will consider account is equal to account minus R2. Depositor is equal to depositor minus R3. We are deleting all accounts at branches located in the Needham. That means all accounts we are deleting from the account. We supposed to delete from account as well as depositor, remember. For that purpose only this query is used, a series of assignment operators. Similarly, insertion. Insertion means specify the tuple to be inserted and we will union it actually. R is a relation. If you want to like to insert a tuple or some set of tuples and that will be written as a query and it is going to be done union means it will be added. Insert means, for example, account union set of values I am providing. In which order the attributes are there? Same order. Like that you can attach the or add the information tuples to the existing relation. Updating. So how to do updation? Updation can be done by using our generalized projection. So R is equal to, we are going to assign the same relation. Pi of f1, f2, etc., fn of R. What are these f1, f2, etc., fi? Fi are the ith attribute updations we are doing. But for all accounts, but not for all tuples, but not only a single tuple. If you want to do for a particular tuple, then you have to write selection constraint. So constraint can be written by us as per our need actually. Make interest payment by increasing all branches, all balances by 5%. 5% enhancement will supposed to be given to all branches. Then you will be considered as a specific application. So, here we are using pi account number, balance, branch name and balance star 1.05. 1.05 means 5% increase. So, we are updating that. That is same is assigned to back to the account means the original relation is replaced with this updated data values. So like that, we can do all DML operations also in relational algebra. But most of the time, we will try to write most of the queries only to access the data only by satisfying our as per the needs of the user group actually. This becomes a very, having a lot of operations and a lot of provision is there to express all kinds of the logics. So that's why this become a basis for our most of the commercial query languages, specifically structured query language SQL, which we'll discuss in coming sessions actually. Thank you all.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.